Benvenuti, benvenuti cari amici di Samuviti in questo nuovo video. Naturalmente come sempre vi ricordo di distruggere il bottone like, di iscrivervi al canale, di iscrivervi anche al canale Telegram. Oggi andiamo a parlare di Cardano e Ripple, ok? Se effettivamente potrebbero avere un'esplosione in futuro, e lo andremo a vedere in particolare con un video molto molto interessante. Per il momento vi ricordo, Cardano ha una capitalizzazione di 93 miliardi più 40% in settimana, quindi veramente un Cardano devastante. Ripple 57 miliardi con 4.7% in settimana. Per cui andiamo subito a vederci questo video da parte di BitBoy e Demone, che mi ha colto l'attenzione e per cui andremo a interpretarlo. Iniziamo subito.
Cardano and XRP, because these are the two big coins that are really leading the way right now. And I guess I'm just going to let you loose here and talk about should people buy Cardano? Should they buy XRP? Should they sell? Let us know.
Yeah, sure. I mean, when you look at the gains for these two coins over the last week, Cardano is up 48% and XRP is up 57%. And some of the people have to realize about these numbers is that, you know, Bitcoin is up like a much less percent. I think it's up maybe 5% for the week, something like that. Ethereum coming in. Bitcoin is up 4% for the week and Ethereum's 5% for the week. So what we're looking at is two coins in the top 10 that have both pumped between 48 and 57%. And these are two coins that we've talked about on my channel extensively over the last couple of months, that these are going to be two of the biggest bang for your buck altcoins in the rest of this bull run. You know, there's been a lot of people out there who said we were in a bear market and everything was going to go down, you know, 85-90%, which will happen at some point, I believe.
Ok, quello che ci sta dicendo BitBoy, che è il personaggio a sinistra, che attenzione che Cardano e Ripple in questa settimana hanno pompato una il 50% e l'altra il 53% in una settimana. Naturalmente lui ci dice, ok, alcune persone dicono che il mercato crollerà del 80-90%, prima o poi lui dice accadrà questo, però secondo lui non è questo il momento.
But, you know, I never gave up that these coins are going to be good investments still for this year. And we definitely are seeing that, you know, that's being proven true at this point with these coins absolutely crushing it. So why are these two in the top 10? Why are they doing so unbelievably well? Well, you know, for Cardano, this is due to we finally had this announcement of the smart contracts coming out. So just so everybody kind of understands, the way a platform like Ethereum or Cardano works is through what we call smart contracts. They're automated actions that have predetermined things that set them up. They're automatic contracts that get fulfilled. Well, you can't really run a decentralized platform without the smart contracts, and Cardano has been chugging along.
Ok, quello che dice lui, sostanzialmente Cardano ha avuto questo exploit perché il 12 settembre arriveranno gli smart contract. Lui dice che una piattaforma decentralizzata non può funzionare senza contratti intelligenti.
On a slow roadmap for a real long time, getting prepared for finally launching its ecosystem. The smart contracts coming out will be the official launch of the Cardano ecosystem. There are tons of projects that are sitting there waiting in the wings to launch on Cardano, but they haven't been able to do it. You know, we've looked at other projects like Giro Wallet or Card Starter. Like, these are projects that aren't really yet fully launched in the way that they will be in the future once Cardano smart contracts come out. So there's been a lot of...
Lui quello che ci dice che ancora tantissimi progetti su Cardano non sono stati lanciati, quindi naturalmente lui è fortemente bullish su Cardano.
A debate in the community, like, how long is this going to take? Well, on Friday, Charles Hoskinson announced September 12th is the date, and that's a very important date because, in my opinion, this bull run ends for Bitcoin at the end of September, for altcoins in between Halloween and November, so into the fall. I know some people subscribe to.
Questo è molto molto importante. Cosa ci dice BitBoy? Ovviamente non sono nei consigli finanziari né di trading. Secondo lui la bull run, pensate, finirà a fine settembre. Ok, per quanto riguarda Bitcoin e per le altcoin tra Halloween e inizi di novembre, quindi l'autunno potrebbe essere, diciamo così, molto ma molto sofferente, ok, per il mercato cripto.
You know, we'll hit all-time highs next year. I think maybe you think maybe quarter one next year. There are other people that believe we're going to be in a much longer bull market. I don't believe any of that. I believe in something called the Bitcoin Golden Bull Ratio, which determines, just to summarize it, September 28th, give or take a week, should be the top for Bitcoin. I would say I'm looking probably at this point, maybe September 25th being the top for Bitcoin, because that's the day the futures contracts for the quarter three close. So I think there's a lot of stuff to suggest that. But
ok, perché lui dice il 25 proprio di settembre? Perché là si chiudono i future.
So if we're looking at Bitcoin peaking at the end of September and we're looking at altcoins peaking sometime between Halloween and November, the fact that September 12th is the date picked for these smart contracts, it's basically right when these altcoins are going to really, really start running and pumping. Fundamental news, mainnet launches, things like that, they don't do a lot in a bear market. But in a bull market, when there's excitement, this can be the news that can push Cardano to the top, making up a lot of ground between it and Ethereum. And then towards the next bull run, these smart contracts being launched means it's going to be a fully robust ecosystem ready for DeFi. So Cardano is going to absolutely crush it and make up a lot of ground on Ethereum. You know, depending on how ETH 2.0 goes, it could pass Ethereum at some point. But, you know, I do caution everybody, Ethereum is much closer to Bitcoin than anything else is to Ethereum right now. So there's some reasons why I think Cardano is going to crush it.
Pensate, lui pensa che Cardano schiaccerà Ethereum, che attualmente ha una capitalizzazione 5 volte quella di Cardano, quindi abbiamo un prezzo di Cardano a $3, quindi lui ritiene almeno $15 per Cardano in questo momento. Quindi potenzialmente, secondo lui, a questo punto ogni un mese, barra due mesi, potrebbe arrivare a questi livelli. Vedremo un po' che cosa succederà. Al momento sembra fantascienza.
All right, so my audience knows that, especially for XRP, I always said that I am I'm not really supporting the XRP idea, but that doesn't mean that you can make money off of trading the XRP price. I don't know if you're a long-term holder of XRP or not, but I guess you're just kind of taking advantage of short-term price action, right?
Well, I think now I'm a long-term holder of XRP. Yeah. I was in the past. I would buy it and sell it like a cheap whore. You know, I wouldn't care about it at all, because I mean, there's a lot of things about it that I don't like and I don't support. But I really think that, you know, in crypto, we're always in like the pointing business. We're like, that coin, I don't like what that coin's doing, or, you know, I don't like this person in crypto. But then you have moments where you realize, like, we're actually kind of all on the same side. And I think the SEC lawsuit has really proven that. Yeah. We've all remembered who the bad guys are. You know, the bad guys are not Ripple. The bad guys are the SEC, one of the most corrupt organizations in the world. The bad guys are the ones that want to come in and regulate to death, so the few stay at the top, and the generational, you know, wealth redistribution that's going in cryptocurrency right now.
Ok, ora siamo arrivati a parlare di Ripple, sappiamo i problemi con la SEC. Naturalmente The Moon non è un grande sostenitore di Ripple, gli dice, ok, tu hai Ripple, però le vuoi holdare a breve termine? BitBoy gli risponde, guarda, io ci credo fortemente in Ripple, e secondo me i cattivi sono proprio quelli della SEC, che vogliono regolamentare tutto fino alla morte.
Oh. They want that to stop because that puts people on a higher footing with them. But regardless, just like you said, regardless of whether or not, like, you know, I look at it kind of like this. Like, if there's a sports team that I absolutely hate, but they're winning, and if I were a gambler and I wanted to get some big gains, I could hate that team, but it's easy money. And that's kind of what I see with XRP right now, is this is easy money. And I think that all of the judgment and the hate towards the XRP army and all the things that they've said over the last few years, I think it's going to age very badly, because it looks like they're right about a lot of stuff. Now, were they getting crazy conspiracy, you know, theory? Were they doing crazy conspiracy theories and reading too much into things? Maybe on some level, but the banks are adopting XRP. The big narrative before was that, oh, the banks were used.
Questa è una cosa molto importante. BitBoy ci dice, le banche stanno adottando Ripple. Questa è una dichiarazione veramente pazzesca.
Using the Ripple technology, but they weren't gonna be using XRP. Now, a lot of people don't know, when Ripple rebranded a lot of their products and came out with RippleNet, you have to use XRP to use RippleNet. You have to use XRP to use their on-demand liquidity service now. XRP is now woven into that entire the UI that is RippleNet that all the banks are going to be using. And we're seeing slowly, one by one in Asia, more banks committing to Ripple. This has already been determined. The banks are going to use Ripple. When you start understanding that 90% of the banks are owned by basically one entity, you really start understanding that these dominoes are falling, but they've been predetermined to fall. So Ripple is out there doing work right now. They're adding so much to what they're offering, and the banks are starting to adopt it. Meanwhile, in the United States, they've got the SEC lawsuit. It's very clear they're winning that lawsuit. It's very clear at worst they're getting a slap on the wrist. How do we know that? Well, we know it from all the news, but we also know it because around the world, they're continuing business like normal. They haven't slowed down at all. They know that they're going to win this. And when that happens, which I'm being told by some insiders on the case, the middle of September at the latest is going to be when this thing is going to be settled. They said things are changing rapidly. It could be much earlier than that. It could change as we get closer to that date. But by the middle of September, the SEC lawsuit should be settled. So in about a month from now. So you think about that September 12th date for Cardano, and you think about the middle of September for XRP, we could be looking at the most explosive altcoin season we've ever seen, led by those two coins.
Mamma mia, queste dichiarazioni di BitBoy veramente mi rendono fortemente entusiasta, perché cosa ha detto? Lui. Ho delle notizie da parte di qualcuno che Ripple sta vincendo la causa con la SEC, questo è quello che dice, e addirittura dovrebbe finire a metà settembre la causa con la SEC. Se ci mettiamo anche che proprio a metà settembre arriveranno anche gli smart contract su Cardano, lui dice questa sarà la più grande high season leggendaria mai esistita. Ora, potenzialmente penso che lui, naturalmente, essendo un personaggio pubblico, debba un po', ok, caricare le persone e così via. Quindi va un po' a fomizzare, ok, in questo momento userei questo termine. Però, attenzione, perché potenzialmente, come abbiamo visto anche più volte dall'altcoin index, a questo momento siamo in zona Bitcoin season, ok, ancora, quindi l'altcoin season non l'abbiamo nemmeno vista. Quindi potenzialmente, sicuramente, potremmo avere un incremento dell'altcoin. Non penso che Cardano andrà a superare Ethereum, ok, questa è la mia idea, poi può succedere di tutto. Naturalmente fatemi sapere anche voi nei commenti che cosa ne pensate. Vi ricordo di distruggere il bottone like, di iscrivervi al canale e ci vediamo presto.